This is how mosquitoes drink blood. First, they land on the skin. They stick in their snout, but the snout has a sheath which the mosquito uses to stabilize the needle. And that stabilizing thing is called the labium. It folds and stays outside. The part that punctures the vein is called the labrum, but there are two cutting jaws that rend the skin apart. Of course, we all know that biting mosquitoes are women. The mosquito is a member of the suborder Nematicera, not all of the members of which are bloodthirsty. So the mechanism for blood drinking sits inside an insectoid shell. How did it appear there? Dmitry Belyaev suggested that the appearance of modern humans during hominid evolution occurred through the agency of stress-related neuroendocrine mechanisms. He argued that the change is brought about by the destabilizing effects of a challenged neuroendocrine system opened up new, untrodden evolutionary paths. I think this is gross. Through stress, muscle and bone was melted and rearranged. Indeed, there is reason to believe that increased brain size in hominids was the main cause of their accelerated evolution. In the winter, in the snow, sometimes, the springtails, or the snowfleas come out and cluster in huge masses. Why do they swarm? Presumably, says Howard Evans, this is preceded by a period in which food, temperature, and moisture are just right in a given situation, permitting a rapid increase in numbers, at the same time causing a decline or at least no increase in numbers of their natural enemies. The food supply, maybe, is then exhausted. The behavior of the springtails changes, and instead of fleeing from light, they seek it. They come out on top of the snow and begin viciously attacking and eating each other. But their bodies are poisonous, and they die off in massive numbers, relieving the glut. Evans compares this to human cannibalism, but I do not think this is an apt comparison. Cannibalism in humans, as I understand it, is not vicious. And consuming human flesh does not harm us. No, it is helpful to us. Then again, when is the effect of cannibalistic activity purely nutrition? In a similarly single-minded way, the appearance of this behavior in springtails leads us to believe they are driven only by rage or spite. But perhaps they are being benevolent. Bugs run from stomping feet. More importantly, they form memories. Caterpillars even retain these memories through their transformation to a butterfly. So, maybe, why did the mosquito drink blood? She wanted to?